Hi, I'm Phil, head of product at EDELRID, and this is the EDELRID OHM II. Belaying a much heavier climber or being belayed by a much lighter belayer, there's always the risk in case of a fall that you either might hit the deck directly, crush into your belaying partner, or when higher up, yanking your belayer into the first quick draw, in the worst case, making him or her lose control of the breaking hand. Weight differences in climbing parties is a much underestimated and serious risk. Introduced in 2016, the OHM was the first compact and practical solution for climbing parties with a bigger weight difference to safely go climbing together. No more additional weights that needed to be tied to the belayer, no more Z-clipping, neighboring roots also adding constant friction to the rope system. With the OHM, you always have the solution in your pocket, indoors and outdoors, to expand the pool of potential belaying or climbing partners massively. And after so long, we wanted to give the OHM a proper facelift to accommodate for needed improvements and to optimize on what we have learned in the meantime. After several years of development, we have fine-tuned the friction unit within the OHM to gradually generate more friction in the event of a fall, while at the same time minimizing falls activations. At first sight, the OHM II looks very similar, and the principle of working mechanism pretty much stayed the same. The installation can start on the ground, right after tying into the rope. Pressing the obvious button on the side of the device, you can slide the device open and insert the climbing rope. Markings on the device guide you to insert the rope correctly. The device is then hung to the harness, and after a thorough partner check, the climber can start to climb. After clipping the OHM to the first possible anchor point in the route, you are all set. Now the climber can climb on freely, clipping further quick draws, and in the event of a fall, the OHM automatically activates, adding much more friction to the rope system so that even a light belayer can safely belay a heavier climber. The integrated swivel now makes it irrelevant how you clip the OHM to the first anchor. It will always orientate itself in the right way. However, we still recommend clipping the carabiner with the gate in the opposite direction of where the route leads to. Finally, the OHM will deactivate whenever there is slack in the rope on both sides of the device. It is as easy as that. An undeniable advantage of the OHM is that the promised added friction that the OHM provides takes into effect the moment you clip the OHM to the first anchor point. No matter how good or experienced the climber is, a fall before the second bolt is always thinkable, and with a very light belayer can result in a dangerous collision or even a fall to the ground. Now, as a belayer, be ready to get used to the OHM. It is easily possible to quickly pay out rope as well as belay very dynamically. If you don't succeed straight away, take some time to practice. Giving out rope fast, for example, is easily realized by moving the guiding hand towards the OHM while paying out slack. As for belaying dynamically, you can find a dedicated video in the video description. Finally, let's take a closer look at what weight difference the OHM can compensate. Different national institutions, associations, and teaching methods will say different things about that and often not make any recommendations at all. As a German company, in the past, we have orientated ourselves to the recommendation the German Alpine Clubs offers regarding this topic. They communicate a weight difference between the climber and the belayer at which climbing together can be considered safe of 10 kilograms. If you exceed this weight difference in a climbing party, you should consider additional methods such as a Z-clip, added weight for the belayer, or even the OHM. For the future, we would like the information what the OHM actually does to be simpler, more transparent, and less dependent on other recommendations. This is why we now only communicate the maximum weight difference the OHM II can compensate for. Climbing party then can or must take this piece of information into their considerations whether it is safe or not to climb together with their weight difference. Over the years, we have improved our method of deriving this number to a testing setup today that is as objective as possible. So let me quickly walk you through that. In various passive belaying setups involving a falling mass and a passively belaying mass, we compare a fall with equal weights without the OHM against the same fall with a weight difference and with the OHM in place. So in detail, we start with a falling scenario of a climber and a belayer with the same weight and no OHM and then gradually increase the weight of the climber with the ohm installed until the test result looks exactly the same as with same weights and no ohm. And that is then the weight difference the ohm compensates for. And we do this with various scenarios, also including a fall scenario in the first quick draw. And as you can see, having the same weight difference with or without the ohm makes massive difference. As we have already found when we were working on the previous version of the ohm, expressing weight differences with a factor is a highly inaccurate and dangerous way of communicating about weight differences. This is why we use absolute numbers. For the OHM II, this testing has led to a maximum weight difference of 25 kilograms the OHM II can compensate. In other words, when assessing the risk of climbing in a climbing party with a weight difference, you should take into consideration the 25 kilo an ohm can offer you when it is used. So in other words, you can assume that your belayer would be 25 kilos heavier. So this is a little bit different to the 40 kilograms we have communicated in the past. But the 40 kilograms already took into consideration the 10 kilograms the German Alpine Club recommends. And additionally, the testing setup we used in the past was less objective than what we are doing now. So by today's standards, the OHM II compensates for roughly 10 kilograms more than the previous version of the OHM does. And there you have it, the OHM II. It is sold with a nice wide sling that is replaceable, as well as this carabiner. So what you should remember, this is the OHM II. It compensates for 25 kilograms in your climbing party, has an integrated swivel, an improved activation mechanism, and works as soon as it is clipped in. The OHM II is the pocket solution to enable more climbers to safely climb together.